All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Adam Kokesh here at the 2018 Libertarian National Convention. I am joined by Dane Posner and TJ Roberts. And Dane is a fellow delegate from Pennsylvania and obviously very brave, wearing a red and black anarcho-communist flag here as a proud member and delegate of the Libertarian Party. And we have TJ Roberts, who is here as press representing Liberty Hangout and someone who distinctly comes from a more right-oriented libertarian perspective. But just to start this off, you both assert the non-aggression principle, is that correct?
Yes.
100%.
Now, what we had here today was a really beautiful moment where we were able to present an opportunity for the Libertarian Party to say, we want to welcome everybody who asserts the non-aggression principle. First of all, do you guys have any background thoughts on you know, this element of the party, you know, being able to unify around principle?
Well, I even asked Nick Sark the other night how he felt about our presence in the party, and he said that libertarianism was originally a leftist philosophy, and he acknowledged that by under the likes of Pierre Joseph Proudhon, Peter Kropotkin, and so he said, yes, that is absolutely welcome in our party. And so I found, since I've been here, that we all, Ancaps, Ancoms, Mutualists, Georgists, we agree on more than we disagree on. You know, we believe that state power is out of control. You know, and we don't believe that that corporations should be given privilege by the state, for instance, because that even undermines, you know, small businesses, and that undermines the right of people. You know, it gives power, takes power away from the people. And so, you know, I felt like we built a lot of bridges so far.
DJ?
Yes. So the moment you joined the Libertarian Party, you signed the oath that says you do not believe in the initiation of force or the threat thereof for achieving political or social goals. So to be a member of this party is to assert the non-aggression principle. This wasn't changing anything, it was just making it loud and clear that the NAP is the first thing that is the most important part of being a member of this party. That is our principle first, to make sure that by having that principle we are able to make a freer society no matter what your personal preferences are.
Well, I suppose we're jumping ahead a little bit. We got to tell the story of what transpired here, because it really was a group of left-leaning or left-inclined libertarians who first wanted to put out this unity statement, because a different version, because they wanted the party to be welcoming of people who are coming from a left perspective. I absolutely share that sentiment. I think we should be welcoming people from the right and the center, and it's around the core principle. And the resolution was debated a little bit on the language. I spoke in favor of it, and it barely failed. It needed two-thirds. It got over 50%, but less than two-thirds. And so I saw this, and I was like, holy crap, this is a big missed opportunity. When I saw you guys going and scrambling to rewrite it, to tweak the language, and you were a part of this, I said, we need to get Mike Heiss over here, because he was one of the loudest voices against this. Unfortunately, he stayed against it, which was really disappointing. But we grabbed TJ. We grabbed a number of people who represented different perspectives.
Joshua Smith signed off on it. I did not expect that. So both, you know, Matt Keenel and Joshua Smith came together. And despite all the chaos that's been leading up to this convention, I feel like that's a huge deal. I mean, that in itself is bottom unity. This is the belief we need to unite against authoritarianism, and that's something that we can all agree upon.
Now, you got to explain bottom unity, Dane.
So it's the belief that we're all opposed to state power. We don't believe that we believe that the power has been taken out of control, and we're being extorted by the state to fund our own oppression. Essentially, the police are against us. Basically,
well, I think we got to step back real quick. You're still missing the premise of this. It's from the square political chart, which I also don't like. I like the diamond better. But the point is that anybody who is at the bottom of that chart, who opposes any kind of anarchist philosophy as the basis of their morality, anybody who asserts self-ownership and those principles, really anybody who's on, like, and bottom, that the part that I do like about this, you're basically saying anybody who's on this half of the line, not even being an anarcho-whatever, if you're on the side of less authority, we should be unified to stand against authority. And that's just so beautiful. And the symbols, as I understand it, you have the black and various colored circles. They're all welcome. But it's also anybody who's in the bottom of the chart. Is that correct?
Yes. Okay. Absolutely. Regardless of economic philosophy, because, you know, that's from, you know, left, as far left and far right. You know, we have mutualists who are more in the middle, Georgists, like I said, Ancoms, Ancaps, all of that are opposed to state oppression. So...
Now, coming being more welcoming to the right, of course, also, we have a definite big opportunity there. I think Ron Paul brought in a lot of people from the right for this movement, and we have more low-hanging fruit, so to speak, coming in from the left. But at the same time, we want to make sure that we're standing on principles in a neutral way. The only anarcho-whatever I've heard coming in from the right would be like anarcho-theocrat, right? Now, there's no big fear of an anarcho-theocrat, you know, incursion into the Libertarian Party, turn it into some, like, religious thing, right? We're not worried about that. But there is some fear, right, that a lefty advocating a different vision of property rights in a stateless society is a threat to someone standing up as with a right perspective on the same principle. CJ, why aren't you afraid of this guy?
One of the reasons that I'm not afraid of Dane is because I primarily recognize the legitimacy of localization. I believe that America is far too big to be governed, and I believe that there's one thing that we can agree on is that people work much better whenever something is decentralized as much as possible. If you wish to turn your neighborhood into a commune where everything is shared, that is within your rights. If you wish to have a neighborhood in which full free market capitalism is embraced, that's also within your rights. So I believe that if we actually accept the fundamental right of decentralization and secession, we can both come to the agreement that we can coexist.
Absolutely. And I believe something we can agree upon is that there's no authority but yourself. Do y'all agree?
Absolutely.
So, yeah, so we all support the right to self-governance. We don't believe that anybody can tell us what's best for us besides us. So that's what we're all here for. We're all libertarians.
And I guess I should read the actual text of the resolution here, just so everybody knows exactly what we were pushing here, because there's an ongoing effort here. And even with our version that we put forth, we got over half of the body, and it looked like it was so close to 2/3, but not quite. And we propose this as the NOLA Accord. Whereas it is necessary for all who passionately oppose injustice to stand together, we, the members of the Libertarian Party, hereby resolve that we welcome everyone who asserts the non-aggression principle, regardless of their preferences, for what a voluntary world might look like. And that's so important because we attach so many labels. And, you know, I mean, I could call myself an anarcho-homesteader because, like, I want to be able to homestead in freedom on my own land. And just even when people want to do that, as anti-authoritarians, we're also very passionate about being precise. And we all have to have our own little group and our own identifier, and I support that, yeah. But there's a natural inclination to that sectarianism, and anything we can find to unify people against authority is just so beautiful. So, guys, any last thoughts on this or what we have to look forward to going into Austin 2020?
Yeah, so I want to say I feel like we built a lot of bridges here at this convention. I did not expect it, and a bunch of my activist friends back home have not seen the Libertarian Party as being accepted to people of our economic philosophy. We feel that the Libertarian Party does not believe in liberty for all, it believes in liberty for a few, the wealthy. And so I feel like after this convention, I can take home to them the idea that, no, there are a bunch of people that do support us, and we do have a place in the party, and, you know, that we are voluntarists. We do believe in a voluntary economic system. We do not believe in establishing, you know, our own communes, our own societies with the use of force. We realize that the state is actively trying to impose its own force to stop it, prevent us from doing that. And so that's something that we all need to unite against.
It's not left versus right. It's not an us versus them. There's only one us versus them, and that is the state versus the people. The people are those that do not have the legitimate right to initiate force. Those are the people that I stand with. So long as that is where it is, the state is our enemy. And with that in mind, we need to unite in order to take out what the true problem is, and that is government. If it were not for government, a leftist would not be able to impose their will upon me. I would not be able to impose my will upon a leftist. So it is the state that we need to be attacking, and not each other. We need to be uniting against our threat.
Well said. Well, this was the first convention for both these guys. We'll see you in Austin 2020. Thanks for watching.
Thank you very much.